Hi everyone. So as we discussed, let's talk about string permutations. Okay, this is can be solved with a recursive or non-recursive way. Initially, I struggle with solving it in the non-recursive way. Then I fall back. Okay, let's do it recursively, because it's like a tree-like structure where you keep one character constant and do get the results from rest of the string like ABC. Simply, if I talk about a three character ABC. Here I'm holding on first character A and I'm playing with B and C. Okay, so what all permutations I will get? So I will recursively call the same, okay, get the permutations of B and C, then concatenate with A. So it will be ABC and ACB. Then I will hold I will put a hold on first index, which is B. I will get the permutation of A and C, which is AC and CA. Okay, this is recursively. So B and C, again, like if you just keeping the hold on character A, you got B and C. Then you call recursively this whole permutation thing, which will hold on to the B, and C is a single character, so nothing will happen, B and C. And then it will hold on to the C character and will get the permutation of single character B. So it's like a CB and B, CB and BC, so ABC and ACB. Similarly, so it's a recursively call, recursive call we'll be keep making. Const string permutations, here we are passing a string and so here we are checking if string dot length is less than 2, base condition, because if it is less than 2, then you can actually return a string. This is a break condition. Less than 2 means there is only single character. No permutation is possible with that. Permutations, it's an empty array initialized. Now, you already know we have a string array, so we can run a loop onto it. Let I is 0, I is less than, first let's get the length, length equal to str.length, okay. And I will see I is less than length, and I plus plus. Okay, here I will get the first character, which is string of I. I got the first character, and here I will get the remaining string, which will be, let's calculate this, which will be string dot slice 0 till I, 0 comma I, and the remaining, which is str dot slice again I plus 1 till end of the string. If you are just not passing the second index, means that is the end of the string. So 0 to I, which is I is 0, that means it will do nothing, and remaining will be I plus 1, so it will be the remaining of string after first character. Okay, now we will run a loop and we will recursively call it. So let sub permutations of, here we will just call the str permutations of remaining string. Okay, here once we get the permutations array, permutations array dot push, we got the first character, and sub permutations, and finally once this loop is over, did we do something wrong? Okay, yes, this one. So we have these two variables, I is less than length, I plus plus. We got the first character and we got the remaining characters after getting the first character. And then we are just running a loop onto it. We are also getting the all the permutations of the remaining string. So we are fixing the first character, and for B and C we are getting all the remaining permutations. And then permutations dot push the first character and all set of permutations. Okay. Finally, we are returning permutations. Okay, so this is how you can actually get the permutations. There is a non-recursive solution also for it, but recursively getting this done is more clear and more good for understanding how we are doing it. Okay, thanks everyone.